Moving forward with our program, we will have the participation of the engineer Walter Moncayo of the OK. Graduated in 1997 as aquaculture engineer from the University and Superior School of El Corán by the Faculty of Marine Faculty. He has more than 20 years of experience in the aquaculture industry, and nowadays he works as a regional manager of sales of Colpel, Ecuador, where he supervises and generates business on farm. Different shrimpers, for tilapias and shrimp, and in his time he has been in charge to develop new alternatives for the use of tools and protocols on the production of shrimp. Topic: production of shrimp in Ecuador using symbiotic models.
Good morning, you all. My name is Walter Moncayo, Regional Manager of Alter Ecuador. For me, it's a pleasure and an honor to be able to participate in this event, and I thank the organizers of CONAQUA. Now I'm going to be talking about the production of shrimp using the symbiotic models. Basically, as we all know, the aquaculture is growing. The paradigm of the use of antibiotics and antibiotherapy has been completely eradicated in Ecuador and several parts of the world. The markets of the post-COVID will ask food that could more in equity or more than 19 China, the US, and the UAE. Of course, they increase and appear new consumers for healthier food and with more traceability. As you remember, we have from the baby boomers to the generation of the Z generation, and those will be our next clients. Inocuity is a very important term in aquaculture. Basically, in the 70s, the FAO disposed of this availability at a world level, and afterwards, it was added the idea, the criteria of the economical access and physical access. And in the 90s, we talk about inocuity. Inocuity means there is a food that is nutritional and, of course, do not damage the environment. In Ecuador, we work at a lot of that concept in OKT with several certifications, different strategies. As we can see, we have the ACC, we have the NATULA, the COSERT, and at the same time, the institutions that rule the aquaculture at the Chamber of Aquaculture work a lot on positioning for shrimp, the best shrimp of the world now, the FCPP. Basically, the idea is to certify of free of antibiotics and with good practices at the production. Talking about production, precisely, we have grown a lot. As you can see on this graph, this slide, in the last 19 years, the growth has been very good. This year, even if we had the effect of the pandemic and the, instead of low consumption, we have seen that we are going to be a little bit of growth, but the sales, fueled by the international prices in the last year, there will be very different to the curve that usually we see. Here we can see at September 9, we see almost a production similar to the last year, with some pikes and some downs. And this quarter, even when the numbers are aligning, they are going to be very good on production. The problem is the price. Something that is common to all of us who work in this field. As we can see from 13 to the 19, we have a drop on the prices non-stop, and in 2020 it's even more, and make that some producers become more innovators and seek strategies to be able to keep their production margins and remain in the business. One of those strategies that we have seen is to change the destination of export. A lot of the shrimp that was only sent to Asia, now we are sending to another place, to Europe and US. But likewise, this is very important, as you can see here, Asha, very important. The shrimp factory change in 5-10 years has changed a lot. Before we had plants like the industry in 2015, but we can see a lot of different views on the horizon, where we can foresee a lot of electric energy equipment, increase of densities, a lot of effect of the golden era that might have been at the time with great productions and with wood prices. The change was basically because introduction smart feeders that we have a lot of reactions, the aeration that has an option that we had since long time ago, nutrition at of high level with companies that work specifically on that, alternative protocols like symbiotics that they are also are being part of the protocols of some producers in the country. Some methods that have made evolution where there used to be no more than 2,000 pounds production, now more than 8,000 pounds. And before, where there was only fresh water and with ionic compensation, work a lot on exchange. And several tools now that they are very valid in the modern production of shrimp that allow to take decisions in real time with the use of computers. And so we have been able to decrease a lot on the cost. Now we have 60-70% of the cost, and the conversion, food conversion, has been adjusted. The growth has been increasing, and we may have more cycles a year. From 5,000 pounds, we have 8,000 pounds, and in others, 10,000 pounds. Bigger growth, better survival, and better quality at the end. The shrimp sector at this 2020 might be uncertain, but we've seen it also as an opportunity. Basically, we've been working a lot on the shrimp parallel to everything that's been going on, and we have put technical criteria of the using less antibiotics, using more natural products to assist on the production without existing losses by diseases. The best business is the innovation is since beginnings, the symbiotic and the fermentation. Here we combine two elements, the probiotics and the prebiotics, so there exists a quality and lack that allow the producers to have a stream that may make good gains on rentability and profitability. We don't talk 1 + 1 = 2. Now we talk 1 + 1 = 3, because there's a beneficial effect of when you come back the probiotics and prebiotics, you get a benefit on the health of the animal. We have symbiotic liquid, as we all know. We have seen a lot of talks about this. Is the supply to water that we need an agent that bind in with a flotability index that may suspend it on the water, the dusty. I will talk about it a little bit ahead. And it's produced and applied in that way, and there's several ways to apply it. Each time, the innovation and the effectivity of the processes or the producers surprises more. So we can have after an effect on the plankton of the pond, and of course on the bacterial flora, probiotic of the pool. That's what we are looking for. Symbiotic solid, as we call it, to understand, is like food, basically, and clean the internal media of the shrimp. It's a process that we began with mother water, mother water, and then we mix it, and then we apply it to the shrimp, and the shrimp will eat the live food, live because it has a lot of probiotics. And the idea is to have ponds like this, that is with zero contamination. The operator can work and walk through the pool without having every formation of moths, and a profitability that guarantee a better end. Why symbiotic now? Why not before and now? Yes. Since 2017, we have seen that the challenges at world level are the diseases. And somehow those challenges, together with the consumption at world level, have been growing up, have been making present themselves. We have a few years with the EMS, white spot, with white patch. That appeared about 3 years ago, and now a new one like crystal larvae. Those make us think and look into that the issue of the disease is very important. But where do they come from? A lot has to do with the handling that we do. But at the time that happened, where did they come? And we can have a good idea that it should have been a good idea that should have been revolutionary. All the diseases centered by the food, by the mouth in the intestine, and there we have a great opportunity. The intestine, we have different dynamics where the good bacteria as the probiotics and are propion, neither good for the animal, and they are diversity and stable. At the time there exists some factor that affect those variables, the pathogens, in our case the Vibrio, enter as opportunists to create a disorder and to produce problems as pathological problems. In this time, on this point, what we can do is to try to do a treatment or some handling to be able to stabilize again. This is very important because the intestine, also of having the capacity of absorbing food, also influences the immunology of the animal. And they are different intestines, as you know. The one of the excreta is very long and they have several kinds of parasites. So we can see from the monographic to the several, we can talk 24 hours, 96 hours. In the case of the shrimp, 40, 50, 1 hour of transit through the intestine. So it's very important on what's going on along that time. And whatever is happening there is efficient and effective. So the Vibrio won't let us that. Vibrio will be always present, increasing the densities, increasing by the increase of production. I know the same Vibrio than 30 years ago. The use of antibiotics exists, make a resistant on those, and now we have new strains of Vibrio, more virulent, more pathogen. The antibiotics did not work. They reported 7 years ago that the antibiotic molecules, they have resistance. The three or 4 months, they already have a resistance to them. And now this is an unequal difference between the pathogens, probiotics, and we have to also offer that to producers. We have to work with probiotics that they are so useful, so the competition might be equal. And the success of the production will be focused not just in one variable, but in several, since the raw material. At the time that we did the symbiotics, apart from we may have infrastructure products, we have to have a control of the raw materials as the primary matters, and we learn the hard way. The dust, if we don't acquire in a proper way, it won't be used. See how impurity we can get out of the local dust, and that after being used on a mesh of 200 micros, but it's not good enough, that goes to the bottom and produces mud. And same thing with the soil. We have seen soil of different qualities that, instead of being a beneficial thing, may be a damage to the pool. Also the different honeys, always there are situations, they try to buy as cheap as they can, but sometimes the cheapest is not the best, because there are a lot of different honeys that they are mixed with traces of alcohol, and that alcohol, no probiotic will grow there. so we can have the derivatives from the agriculture. But if we, the best product, once again, but if we don't have them, the open mind to the times that they are changing, we won't be able to develop symbiotic or any other protocol. I believe that this year has been a year of learning to OFASAL. Those who remain in the business, up to a point we have changed the handling of the production on conditions completely adverse to us. And that shows that in times of change, who is open to learning, they will be surviving the future. And those that believe that they know all, they are equipped for a world that is no longer here. Every time is something new, every quarter is a new challenge. I'm talking about challenge, and that we cannot ask that the symbiotic help on this situation. Here won't help any symbiosis, neither here. Here is very complicated. We have minimal conditions to be able to make that the symbiotic stays on the pond and be obtain the benefit of it. And we talk of a small and brief history of the symbiotic on Ecuador. And about 5-6 years ago, we had a crisis, a pathological crisis, a very strong one. Several declared that there was EMS and larvae. The crisis was higher, and we treat different technologies, different products. And we were able to see that when we combined those technologies, when we get the best results. The emergency protocols at world level that were an option to prevent and control the diseases. The symbiotic, see it with very, very conservative, but we will see that in America had better and better results. So we began a pilot test and we extrapolated into the field. Definitely, the initial objective was to see the object. How did it work, and we start to see improvements in all the process. The use of symbiotic technology in the shrimp involves probiotics or technology on sequestered and kidnapped in some enzymes and functional food. Why so many options? What we usually need is the probiotics and enzymes, and that's it. Well, basically here we work in a holistic way with everything that we may add, so the probiotic is stronger at the time that it starts to work in the challenge that we have at the production. It's easy to work probiotic and harness, but it won't be the same super probiotic soup that has been enriched with several nutrients and with different technologies. That's where they come, the different formulas from the soy and the application of the dusty. The symbiotic in our country, because this was a thing that we saw with the clients, has given the benefit of almost 13% at the end. This is super, super important, because with the most cost is the food in Ecuador. The average also have lower, has increased 15% the survival and 10% of the cost production per kilo. At the time that we see that you may think that all Ecuador is truly symbiotic, but the thing is the challenge that they put it into practice in the daily production, and that has been the process, the real challenge. On symbiotic, there are no recipes, the technology fits. Basically, we have to have an open mind. As we know, the natural equilibrium that does exist change at the time that we change densities and apply a balanced food. And we have used for several times the traditional probiotics. You can see here in the white teacher is a regular probiotic, like there has been working 20 years. And we have a honey kind probiotic. We always have to do more consecutive applications, and the curve drop on the pound otherwise. And they came the idea of someone at some point Asia, and
with
our friend David, which we wanted to apply a source of carbon to sustain the activity of the probiotic for a longer period of time. This was something very interesting because basically it's used a carbon source that exists in the area. And in our case, like the rice, the bran of rice, and it's a particle of the bran also, with different names we use. But anyway, the beneficial, they are good for the probiotics, source of life for the probiotics, and it's very versatile, could be used in different areas, in different production methods. They produce benefic metabolites. The particle of the dust becomes like a reactor where the bacteria lives and produce enzymes and organic acid, and those metabolites inhibit the increase of the vibrios, and they stay floating in the column water. They remain floating, do not become a mud, and produces benefic plankton. It seems like when it's applied that it starts to grow up a species of plankton that we did not see before. So the size should be less than 200 micras, and this should be always a source of carbon available within the parameters here that they call the 44%. We don't use shells or the dusty cells. They have a lot of just shell that they swap the floor and put it into a sack. No, here we want to sell the structure that remains where the rice decompose and not what is at the bottom. Here is a protocol of David. Here, as you can see, here the different densities, different amounts of dust activated from 0.5. Always taking into consideration, always observing that there do not exist a decrease on the oxygen. The opposite might be, so we can focus on the idea. You can see the idea. But there's always a control here. Do not put 10 ppm if we are putting 8 animals per square meter. It will be a lot and may decrease the oxygen. But put the right amount that has been proven production. The symbiotic, basically this is the formula that we have seen, 10 kilograms of dusty for a hectare in 10 liters of water, and you put the probiotic, the enzyme, and the manato that destroys the vibrios. We use a ppm before seeding. This is very important. The idea to mature the spawn before seeding is something very good, because also that there may be plankton available. There's a lot of probiotic that they already grow there, and is colonizing the whole pond too. When the animal goes into the brewery, the pound, the raceway, they will find a probiotic population that will help it to defend of the pathogens. Of course, the vibrios should be attenuated so they won't be virulent. That's very important. After that, when the application might be regulated because of the seccidis, that's more or less we have seen. You can see an example here of a good dust of good quality and another one that is more dirt than dusty. And here we can see still, here are pieces of rice. If we apply it to the pool, this it will be mud at the bottom, and we are contaminant. This here is a dusty brain that has been filtered, and you can see it this way, but if you saw it before the filtering, it was a super filter, dusty with a great appearance. There's going to be, you will see a lot of that. This is a dusty that has been filtered. The idea is that the particles are between 200 to 300 micras, so they have a good index of flotability, acceptable, and sustain themselves on the water column, cleaning the pond. There's different ways of
promover
promote
esta
this
fermentación
fermentation. As you can
utilizando
see,
la cápsula
there's a capsule
utilizada con
here,
anterioridad para hacer
like
transportes,
what we use
pero
on
ahora se está
Tilapia, but now it's
utilizando
been
para
used to
fermentar polvillo
ferment brand
y
dust
no tiene aireación.
and has no
Lo que tiene es
aeration. What
una
they
bomba
have
en
is a
donde
pump
básicamente
where
mueve el agua
basically
una
moves
vez
the
al
water
día,
a few times a
una
day,
hora y
one
al día
hour,
siguiente
and next
vuelve el
day
agua
they
nueva.
do it again.
Acá vemos
Here we
otra
have another
noticia
one at the
felices con
beginning
esto.
with this
Líneas de aire
la
suave
airlines, soft
en tanques
airlines in tanks
a pequeña
in
escala.
small scale. And well,
Los
the
probióticos, como te
probiotics as the
manejamos,
one that we
estos probióticos
handle,
que
the
pueden estar
probiotics that they might
que
be
están
in
totalmente siendo hechos
completely on anaerobic
anaerobiosis
fermentations and
y
anaerobiosis,
no
and
necesitan
they don't
aire.
need
Entonces
that amount.
pueden
They
ser
might be
puestos al pie de la
put
piscina para ser
close to
usados
the pump to be
inmediatamente
used
en el momento que
immediately
ya
at
esté
the time
activado
that is
el
activated the
probiótico.
probiotic.
Tienen que bajar
They
al
have
pH
to
como
lower the
entre 3.3
pH
y
at 3
3.8.
pH of 3.8,
Y mucha gente
and
lo filtra
several
o
people
usa el
filter.
sobrenadante. Esto es
We
muy
use the
importante porque
overflow,
para
the
nosotros también fue un
overflow.
aprendizaje muy duro.
For us was a
Utilizábamos
very
todo,
hard learning.
reutilizamos
We
entonces
reuse
el
the
sedimento que
sediment
quedaba en
that
el
was
fondo
at the
y eso
bottom,
tampoco es
and
bueno.
that is not
Ya
good.
la fuente de
The
carbono está
source of
agotada, ya las
carbon has
bacterias
been
se lo
deployed,
comieron
the
y solo
bacteria
utilizar el
ate it, and
sobrenadante
just to use
asegura que no
that,
exista formación de lodo y que haya más polvillos
there is
suspendidos en
more
la
dust.
piscina. Se aplica de
It's
diferentes
applied in
maneras.
different ways.
Acá está aplicando por mano, por bomba, en un sistema
Here it's been
un
applied by
sistema
pump,
de intensivo.
an intensive system,
O si no, en el
or the
semi-intensivo que tenemos
semi-intensive
nosotros
that we
con la
have when the
aplicación es de esta
application
manera,
is in this way,
por medio del apago.
through the
Y lo que provoca es que
shovel,
se
you
ve
can see it.
una
We
mejor
see an
mortalidad del
improvement in the
plancton,
quality of
se
the
ven más
plankton. You can see
peces,
more
se ven más
diatomeas,
mamíferos, más
more
cuadrúpedos.
otíferos, copeps.
Detritos, que es un
And
detrito
detritus, which
bueno,
is a good
una
detritus
fuente de
because it's a
alimento
source
también
of
para el
food
plancton.
for the shrimp.
En estos plantas que no
We
habíamos
saw
visto antes,
plancton that we
en
haven't
algún
seen
momento,
before. We found this
no afectó
did
al
not
camarón, pero
affect the
sí
shrimp, but
nos asombró a nosotros
it was
cuando vimos ese
it
plancton.
surprised us when we were
¿Y
able
qué
to see
debería
it.
tener esto?
And
Un
it should
agua
be
con una
like this, a
cantidad
water
de una calidad de
quality,
color y calidad
with the
plantativa.
quality of
Y
good plankton.
el objetivo principal
And
de
of
poner
course, the main
calidad
objective
en
in
probiótico,
is
calidad en
probiotics, the
probiótico.
quality of them.
Esta
This
agua
water
está altamente
is
cargada de
highly
probióticos.
charged with
Por la
probiotics
maduración que se
for the
hizo antes de la
maturation
siembra y
prior to the
después por las
seeding
aplicaciones
and
que
the
se hicieron
applications that they were done
posteriormente a la siembra.
afterwards.
En Ecuador
In
vemos
Ecuador
esto.
we see this.
Pueden ver cómo
You can
entra
see
el
how the
agua
water goes
con una
in
coloración verdosa
like something
después de
green,
dos
but after
semanas.
2 weeks
Observamos que
we
ya tiene una
observe it
coloración
have
amarga.
a
La aplicación
brownish
se volvió
color,
blanqueó,
the
lo que
application of
hizo
the
que quedara
dusty,
alta en nitrógeno, cambió
high
la
in
dinámica del
nitrogen
plancton
changes the dynamic of the
luego
plankton, and of course of
de la
the
cantidad de probióticos
amount
que
of
tenemos en
probiotic
esa
that
agua.
we used to have on that water.
El termolvido en Ecuador es una prueba que hicimos. Fue
The
muy
dust in
interesante porque
Ecuador,
se aplicó
it
con
was
regularidad
applied
casi 30
on
aplicaciones
regular
que nos
basis
costaron
almost 30
no más
times.
allá de $60 en
They
cada
did
ciclo,
not cost us
pero
more
obtuvimos
than
casi 4.000 libras
$60 per
más,
cycle, but we
casi
have more
4.000 libras
4,000
más de
pounds
camarón
more of
con
shrimp
fondos
with
limpios
clean bottoms
y con un ROI aproximado de
and
1 a 10.
one
Entonces
proportion of 1
se
to
puso en
10.
evidencia
So
el
it was
fenómeno de
evident that
Gleason,
this
donde
was a
podía también
trend
ser
that
aprovechado
might
en
be
países.
used in the
Cuando se
country
hizo esto en
when
su
it was
momento.
done this at the time.
Revisamos también micrológicamente
We
nuestra
review our
concentración de
concentration
lactobacilos
of
levadura.
lactobacillus, of
Estaban arriba 1 por 10 a la 9.
Yields.
Y desde luego había vibrios, pero
And
no había
they
vibrios
were vibrios,
atenuados.
but they
No
were
tenían
attenuated.
virulencia.
They were not virulent.
Aquí vemos otro
We have
conteo
another
epidemiológico.
counting,
Y aquí
and
sí
here
llegamos 1 por 10
we
a la
were
3, 1 por
1
10 a la 10, 1 por 10
10
a la
to the
9.
13 to the
Entonces
9.
aquí
Here
determinamos lactobacilos, bacilos y
we check for
levaduras. Básicamente el
lactobacillus, bacillus,
probiótico que
and
usamos es un
yeast.
probiótico que tiene
We use a
un cóctel
probiotics with a cocktail of
de bacterias benéficas que
beneficial
asegura que
bacteria that
exista un
make sure that
consorcio de
there's a
probióticos
group
activados
of
en el agua.
activated probiotics activated. The
En otro
probiotics
capítulo,
and another
básicamente como
soy.
decía, aquí
Here we
aplicamos
apply
un
a
alimento
food
que es la torta
that
de
is
soya,
the
que no entra a sustituir
consolidated
la
soy
soya, sino
that
que
do
entra
not
a
substitute the
complementar
balanced food. It
básicamente por un tema de salud.
complements only
Explicaré
for the
por qué.
health issue.
La fórmula es
this
esta,
is the
son dos
formula.
pasos.
Two
Primero,
steps.
la mezcla
First,
de
the
todos los
mixture of
aditivos
all the
en el agua madre
additives
que
on the
se introduce
mother
en la
water
piscina.
here in
Luego
the
se
pump,
mezcla
and
con
then
la
it's
soya.
mixed
Y
with the
entonces usted
soy, and the third
explicando
step is
algo
to
tal cual
apply
como
it.
un alimento.
Just
No,
like a
nunca en
food.
alimentadores.
Never,
Hasta
never in
ahorita todas las
feeders.
pruebas que se
All
han
the tests
hecho
that
han
have been
sido
done
No ha sido buena
have
y
not been good, and
básicamente
basically
la aplicación del boleo
the
nunca ha mezclado con los otros alimentos
just
porque el animal va a preferir la soya
it out is good enough.
Que él mismo
the animal will prefer the soy
because
it's like something more palatable for them than the brand food. With a density of, we said food with a density, we a low density, we get of ROE almost of 5, 1 to 17, because there are different benefits on conversion factors, like lower cost of the produced stream and better
survival.
So in a controlled environment where balanced food, and there was a substitution of 50%, with the soy conglomerate, we saw a benefit that the cost of the activated soy is almost 40% less of the cost of the food and the beneficial than the and the production, like the conversion, the final cost, and the survival, the additional survival. The benefits of the soy conglomerate were similar to the dusty brain, but it all adds to the benefit of the shrimp, adding probiotics. And like food, here comes fermented soy. They are more probiotic than living on the earth. They produce benefic metabolism of various organic acids, enzymes that help to clean the intestine and improve the absorption of the nutrients. It's a source of protein for the shrimp. The soy is more protein. Not like the dusty carbon, do not produce contamination since it's bound with probiotic and enzymes. The enzymes are inoculum, so make it the balance because it's in a process of transformation of fermentation. If there's any waste, it transforms quicker than the balanced food and produces less risk of increasing the ammonia. Lower the conversion, also diminish the price, and strengthen the microbiome. Here, adding the super additives. The products mixed with an amount of water, 20% on operative levels, and it can be together with put together with the filtered water. As you can see, it's nothing of the other world. There's people that are turning it around, so there are not different conglomerates here, and anaerobic here, it has to be completely sealed. There shouldn't be a lot of air, but we are going to put mother water, so there's no movement of air after 24 hours. The first step, mix it with the soy conglomerate, and we can see a water different to where we put the products because the probiotics should be activated. We can see bubbles. It should be like this. Once I found application of the additives, and the next day it was like this. Never should be like this. And should bubble like this, like if you put an Alka-Seltzer or something. It's the production of gas of the probiotics. A low pH, pH 4.4, 3.98. The pH should decrease, there's acidification of that mother water, and it's ready to mix that soy conglomerate. They should go through a quality control, as I mentioned. We have learned as per the field condition, what we can use on the production conditions. In real production conditions, we have to, when the particle was very weak, we have to discard soil like this. It was not in good shape. Here comes the mixture. The idea is to mix pretty good, so all the soy and all the mother water that is impregnated of probiotics and enzymes is very well covered. Very well covered. Here we have a bed coverage to 100% because particles of soy that do not get together with the mother water, when we use it in the pond, is going to produce contamination. So the relation is one to one, 1 liter of activated water by 1 kilo of soy. And lixiviation produces something like this, and easily we can leave it 24 to 48 hours. And then there's several ways to mix it in Ecuador. People have made this to do that. They are using mixers from the hospital that increases the efficiency of the mixture. As we can see here, when we take it out, we use, since they are hermetics, they put it in plastic so there exists a better anaerobic function. But what we have here are several things that they use sacks, and we have a weight unit specific that we can calculate the amount of product that is going to be used. The application when spreading is always, you work with the foods, and usually on the automatization here, it forms a kind of cube that is warm. It's almost warm for the activation of the bacteria. It applies as such, drop on the pool, and the stream goes to it. And you can see the sizes, different sizes in the particles, but one day the stream accepted and eat it. The quality control is very important. We are always using Vibrios, and it's important to see if the prebiotic is activated. There shall be lactobacillus, bacillus, levaduras. Here we can see different differences as per the different probiotics that are were being used. And the growth that we can see it, and a positometer, and do even some counting of bacteria and yeast. Something very interesting that we did is to compare the effect of the soy and pellet together with organic acids, commercial in a petri dish where it was it, vibrio, green vibrio of deceased shrimp. As we can see, as in the time that we still do antibiograms for the antibiotics, and the soy is very important. You see, there are other acids with some acid, but the soya one is super good. That means this is happening in the tissue of the shrimp, and it's natural production of organic acids and metabolites that inhibits the vibrio. We have done several tests in different things, and the level should be 10 to 14, 1 at 11 in the case of the lactobacillus, and 1 per 10 at 8 on the yeast. Vibrios, of course, there's presence of vibrios, but the ideal is that they are not present. But if they are there, they are not an ambivalence, 1 per 10 at 1, 1 per 10 at 2. Interest is also that the feeding conversion was adjusted. We can see a comparison here between the same fields, the same shrimpers in 2017 compared with 2018, and we can see that there are conversions of a higher level going the two. Conversion 2 and then to 1.5. That was because of the effect of the bacteria flora, the enzymes, if we put it in the intestine of the shrimp. It is a machine to absorb the food, and if it's not in good shape, not good infrastructure, it's a deficient machine. At the time that we improve the health of the intestine with the probiotics, very activated and enriched, we increase that absorption of the food, and the conversion lowers, not necessarily at the consumption level of food, because the conditions may improve. We see growth at the level of the different intestine, 1.10 at the 5, 10 out of 5 in lactobacillus. This is very interesting because you can say you have done analysis of everything in the intestine. The probiotic will be present there? Yes, it's present there. In Stream also there is present the probiotic. They had an excellent they work very good there and almost herbivorous. There were not a lot of problems, diseases. Something interesting to notice when we began with this idea, it was not the criteria of adding soy to the conversion to the table, food table that you have. You have 100 kilos, just put 50% additional. No, it's to substitute. The risk that we had is that we shouldn't even change the level of growth and production. And a plan was made of this type: 30% of substitution the first month, 20 the second, and 10 from the third month until harvest. And after it introduces the variable of the criteria of the technical, the observation of the technical prevails because the green is soy, the other is balanced. We begin with 20 and it will change, and we observed that instead of being minor, the interaction of the soy was bigger because the technician started to see that it didn't lose growth and was saving more when you soy, when the growth was sustainable. Here we can see the red is soy and the blue is balanced food. The interaction was very similar. Here were peaks and decreases, and the biologist, he chooses at what time use more or less. If he saw that the growth may be slowing down, he adjusted, decreases the soya and increases the balanced food, or the other way around. So that way, guaranteed that the rentability was the proper one without losing growth. Here was more stable. We started in 1 month with variation, with a small delay in the growth, where they improved with the food. And lot of stability too. Everything is in function. There is no recipe. Everything has to be done by the technician. The observation on the field is very important. We have a healthy organism. We can see it on the intestine. And we can see if it's feeding properly, if the food is doing wrong to him, if we have a full intestine and empty, and we can see it there. The difference of what there is, and is the shrimp feeding from mud. We can see the intestine black, and here after applying the soy, they are intestines brown, clear. 1 hour, 1 hour and 40 minutes, you do the sampling and see if the population needed yes or no the soy. It might seem that there is an attractability so strong that they like the soy better. The shrimp, shrimp with soy, shrimp with soy, shrimp with soy, balanced, shrimp with soy. The left looks more mud. The beneficial will be around 13%, 50%, and 10% of those production index. In a particular case of Ecuador, with clients that they have used and get benefits of the symbiotic protocol. We did a test just feeding with soy conglomerate, and it was very interesting that it did not, after 14 weeks, we had 29 weeks, more 3,000 pounds, with a seed of 10 animals per square meter, but with the problems of food, good soil, with bottoms, and good organic material. And the soy, we thought that the soy 100% may affect the bottom of the ponds, but no. This way, in function, just to get 3,000 pounds and 10 animals per square meters. After that, we will have to do a bigger study. When we wanted to do it, it looks like the growth stops. That's why the activated soy or symbiotic. Specifically, the objective is the health intestine, not to substitute the a balanced food. The shrimp eat his saliva and food with the activation of the probiotics, no antibiotics, and we don't stop fires, we just prevent things that may happen.
Basically, as conclusion, we can see that there is, after a year, where there's several crises, and along those 3 years, we've been using the protocol. There is the evidence that offers a health factor to the organisms. We found at the beginning, we're still learning from this. And there's a lot of innovation, and a lot of that has been done is basically to improve the conditions so these express better. It's still an artisanal production. We have improved the controls and biosafety. Always can be improved with a high potential of doing it better. This process can be done in real and different conditions, fresh water, salt water, and in salt lands, salty lands, on agricultural lands. It's very interesting to see that with the proper technologies, we can do a better thing on the soil to benefit the animals and, of course, of the dusty brain. And a great potential on the production of, on the long term. Definitely, in the intensive health function, we know that also in Central America, at level of super intensive has worked and still seeing good results. Arabia Saudita, they are observing a lot of interest and a lot of exercise to apply the symbiotic on their production system, super intensive. And well, I thank you all to let me share with you this information, and I hope that you have an excellent closing of the year and that 2021 bring you blessing and prosperity. A huge embrace from Ecuador, friends of Mexico and the world. The swing will continue just to surpass or cross over this patch. Thank you so much for your attention.